Alright, people. Welcome back. More Daily Duels. I must apologize in advance. If you hear some thundering and storming outside, it's raining. In Vegas. What? Yeah, it's raining right now. It is. Oh, you hear that? You hear that? Yeah, I know. Like, what? Like, and it got super dark hella quick, though. I was like, hola. Why is it so dark? Like, I took a nap, woke up about 3. And I woke up, took a nap, woke up about 3, and it was dark as hell, man. I thought it was freaking like, oh my god, I thought it was like 6. Like, it's dark, it's dark. I was like, holy crap. And then I was like, yeah, it's raining. I'm like, ooh, raining in Vegas. Okay, I see you. Anyway, I want to go ahead, as you can clearly see that I tell, I want to go ahead and discuss a little bit of this thing that we call competitive Yu-Gi-Oh! Because competitive Yu-Gi-Oh! Is, in my opinion, a totally different thing than just regular Yu-Gi-Oh! Because it changes you, you know? It really does. So, on my last singles duels where I was playing with Cleese on Wednesday, I got, quote-unquote, demolished by you guys. Like, oh my god, you guys wanted my throat. Like, usually I would get, like, maybe 1 to 2 dislikes. Generally, not many dislikes. I'm not big enough. You know, I'm not big enough to, oh, wow. I accidentally unclicked. I was clicking the wrong shit. I did. I clicked the wrong shit. Might be. Yeah, I'm sitting here trying to click my monsters. I'm like, no, not that one, this one. Not that one, this one. So, my bad. But, I don't get that many dislikes. I got 3 dislikes. You guys dislike my video. You guys don't like me. I don't care. Dislike don't mean anything. You know, I personally, I just don't like the dislike system because I don't know what you dislike. I'm assuming that you guys dislike my video because I was talking about shit. Tons of comments in comparison to my usual amount of comments stating that I was talking shit, that I'm saying that everybody's bad and skinless trash and shit, and I was playing Tower Turbo in the tournament. So, look. Of course, Tower Turbo's a saggy fucking deck. But the question is, do I give a fuck? No! And the reason why is because it's different. That's competitive Yu-Gi-Oh! There's a difference between competitive Yu-Gi-Oh! And fun Yu-Gi-Oh! And sometimes it's really hard to see the difference. But you gotta put your glasses on because there's a difference. There really is. And it's actually interesting how much people can change when it comes to my opponent quitting, because I don't blame them, because, of course, this is a competitive deck, if it really is. So, like I said, we'll go ahead and get another duel, and I'll continue talking. Be right back. Alright, back. So, competitiveness, it brings the so-called negative out in people, and I definitely agree that, generally, Yu-Gi-Oh! Is, you know, a fun game, but then, of course, when you get competitiveness involved, that's when it starts to get like that, and you might have noticed it. I noticed it, and sometimes it's just how Yu-Gi-Oh is. It really is. I don't have my scale set up, so I'm not gonna try. I'm just gonna hopefully try to lock it down through my field spell and monster effects. Hopefully, you know, when this deck can't pendulum summon, it goes slow. I must say, when this deck cannot pendulum summon, it goes slow. We're gonna go ahead and summon Raccoon. Mr. Raccoon, get your search on. That's it, because I can't set up my scales. I mean, like, really, like, what am I doing? Tell you the truth, not much. I'm gonna give me cat, just to keep me flushed with monsters. And I can only activate the effect of Pegasus once per turn, so even if I activate another Pegasus, it doesn't matter. Yeah, man, I mean, if you activate another Chicken Race, you get to activate the effect. You activate another freaking Cosmoton, you get to activate the effect. But no, they wanted to make sure that they say you can only use this effect with Majespecter Pegasus once per turn. Then you just keep on switching out your Majespecters and getting more pluses and more pluses. Okay, that's fine. But I gave my persona of a competitive Yu-Gi-Oh! Player a name because I kind of wanted to, because I thought it'd be funny, but I wanted to differentiate the difference between Yubel Mastery, or Daniel, the guy who's playing Yubel, Derek's on freaking DN and unrated, not even giving a shit, playing Yubel, and Dirty Dam, or the person who wants to win. Like I said, it's competitive Yu-Gi-Oh! And when you start getting some competitiveness into it, okay, so obviously he's gonna come after me, so I'm gonna clearly have to get you with a card, because it's not like Bear can throw the chair at me, so let's go ahead and ban. Oh, which one does this do? Oh, no, it just destroys. I thought it banished. Wrong card, then. Wrong card. My bad. This sucks. This really sucks. I'm gonna have to pretty much, I'm just gonna... Oh, wait, no, because I can summon him and set my scales. Okay, never mind, I'm good. Never mind, I'm good. I'm about to say, man, it sucks. I can't set my scale. But I can set my scales with the Majespecter that I'm searching. So, really, I just need someone who's a 5. Like, anybody who's a 5. Yeah, I'll take you. And I mean, scale 5, not a rating 5, because all y'all are ugly. I mean, look at you, man. You look like a 2. Okay, I'll shut up. But when you get into that competitive aspect, it's like, think of Yu-Gi-Oh! As like a sport, you know? I think my opponent quit because I couldn't activate anything. Think of it as a sport, you know? You go out and you go ahead and play some freaking flag football with your friends. That's fine, you know? You're having fun, you're chilling, you know? It's just you and your friends, right? It's not nothing competitive about it, right? You know, there's a competitive aspect, but there's nothing too much, you know? Someone wins, someone loses, but in the end of the day, you're all still friends, you know? It's all good, it's all gravy, right? But then when you add an incentive to win, you know, like, think about it. If you went out with your friends and said, hey, let's play a fun game of flag football. All right, let's go. We play, okay. Someone's a winner, someone's a loser, but in the end of the day, nothing changes, right? Like, we're cool. We're still golden, right? On the other hand, let's say, all right, well, let's put a little bit of an incentive. You know, winning team gets $50. Each person gets $50. Oh, shit. Now I definitely want to win. I want to win that $50. It's the same thing. It's exactly the same thing. Whether it be locals, I want to win that store credit. Whether it be, you know, at regionals YCS, I want to get my invite, you know? As soon as there's an incentive to something, that's when you start turning. And, you know, the whole idea of having fun gets thrown out the window. Man, fuck fun. I want to win. I want to get mine. And that's exactly what happens when it comes to locals. And that's why I gave myself the persona Dirty Dan. Because when I give myself persona of Dirty Dan, you know what my intentions are. You know exactly what I'm after. I'm after that pussy. Hello? No. No. I am after whatever the prize may be, whether it be, you know, an invite or something, yeah? And another thing that incentivizes me to get dirty with it is because my luck is low. I have booty luck. My luck is like, what? Like, how could a person be so unlucky? That's how bad my luck is. So when it comes to, you know, entering tournaments and stuff, I try to go with either one of the dirtiest decks or, you know, one of the most consistent decks to go against my bad luck and hopefully do well. So despite, you know, how bad my luck is, hopefully the deck will be consistent enough or dirty enough to just crush my opponent despite that. And that's exactly how I want it to go down. You know? So am I saying that Tower Turbo is more skill-based than any of the decks that I face? Definitely not. So scoop it up. Of course, I get another duel because I'm not talking. Bye-bye. All right. So, like I was saying, do I think that my Tower Turbo deck is more skilled than any other deck that I face? Definitely not. I mean, I face a guy who's playing Burning Abyss. I'm sorry. Burning Abyss is one of the most skilled decks I know of. Like, I fuck up all the time with that deck. Like, I can't get that deck straight. I really can. So, you know, definitely not. I definitely think that that's a very, very skilled deck. I really do. So, really, it comes down to, I'm just talking shit, you know? I'm already hyped up by the fact that I won. So, why can't I? I've earned the right to talk some shit. It's just like in sports, you know? You know, you don't think that, you know, whatever team wins the freaking Super Bowl ain't, you know, I don't know what team won the Super Bowl. I forgot. I don't know. But whenever team wins the Super Bowl, you don't think that they don't deserve the right to talk shit? I mean, because in the end of the day, they still won. They deserve to go ahead and talk that shit. So I was happy, you know? Like I said, I have terrible luck. And the majority of the time, I lose. So when I won and I finally win something, then hell yeah, I'm hyped. I'm excited. I won something. All right, well, see, I'm using Majespecters. And, of course, you assume that, you know, that you're going to get off your play. Hopefully you get the right one. Because if you get the wrong one, you're about to get fucked up. So you got lucky. Because if you would have hit this, and I would have hit you with this on your Pendulum Summon, this card's like a black one. Like, this card's like, you Pendulum Summon, a monster special summon, like, bam, get you. So you got lucky. You got lucky that you sniped out the correct card. Because I would have got him. I would have got all this shit. So, So he's just gonna target himself and then add him Performer Pals. He plays Performer Pals in his deck? Oh! I forgot he was a Performer Pal. I just saw that fucker like a couple minutes ago. I just saw his ass. I completely forgot. See? Like I said, he wouldn't be doing these plays. You got lucky that he sniped it out. Like I said, there's luck in Yu-Gi-Oh! There's competitiveness in Yu-Gi-Oh! And it brings out the darkness in people. Yeah. So, another thing that I want to go ahead and address is, of course, I put up the video about me, you know, winning at my victory pack openings that you guys, of course, saw. And that's fine. And, because there's no point in me destroying them, because they're just going to go back to Ashback. What's the point, right? Right? Right. And I did not open up that well, either. Oh, and then you're going to play my fucking monster. Like, look at this man. Look at this man. Playing my monster. Like, it's clearly... It says Majespecter, right? Magister. Not Majespecter. Magister. So you gonna use my fucking monster. Hello? So I guess I'll go ahead and summon you and then search. Like I said, we can both... We can go at it, sir. Just sucks that I don't have fucking... the right shit. Like, at all. Like, I did not open up well enough. I'm not sure if I can combat this duel. This is going to be an interesting one, to say the least. Oh! Oh! Oh, no, 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 no. Y'all, there you win. Oh, have not! Woo, you got it. You got it, sir. You got it. We're back. Whew. Oh, wow. That man kicked the shit out of me. He sniped out the right card to go ahead and snipe out. He fucking wavering knives on it. That's like, that's it. Like, I didn't even open up that well, so you just, shit. Shit! Anyway, on the video, I do my openings, and then you see my friend Sebastian. He's like, oh, fuck you, fuck you. He's a competitive player, I must say. He is a competitive player, and, you know, I thought nothing of it. You know, I think someone commented, and we're like, oh, yeah, that guy was an asshole. No, it ain't even like that. Even like that. We're on the same fucking team, you know? So, it ain't even like that. Wow, I opened up. Now I open up well. Like I said, if I would have fucking opened up like this against the other guy, that last duel, I would have fucking beat that ass. But instead, I opened up like booty. So, that's awesome. Yeah, I'll go ahead and get both effects. And it's literally all the fun of it. It's literally all the fun of it. You know, I'm about to say, you want to play something? Like, you want Maxi? Too late now. It's an inherent summon. You can't change it. You want to Veiler me? I can't retard it. You want to, you know, Ghost Ogre Snare at me? Then I ain't gonna work either. So right now, him dueling me, he has to break my scale. He has to break my scale and kill my monsters, which is very difficult. Like I said, Majespecter's just like, what? It's like, you gotta kill... They can't be targeted or destroyed by opponent's card effects. The way you kill them is by battle, but... I ain't gonna do shit. Like, see? I ain't gonna do shit. But then... But then you give them fucking spells and traps that get rid of monsters. So it's just like... I mean, it's a good thing that they say, you know, tribute. You know, straight up, if these shit said, like, oh, you know... Well, actually, then no, because then you could summon them back in and search again. Like, it's just... Oh, my God. Like, why? Why do they fucking make this deck? That's it. And, you know, sometimes I'm fun. Let's go have fun, play Yu-Gi-Oh! I'm not in it for the glory. Yugioh Mastery. Damn. Right? And, you know? But then there's sometimes letters like this, where I'm just like, this deck is dirty. I know it's gonna be competitive, and I'm playing it competitively. Dirty damn. So, you know, it's just the way the cookie crumbles. It's really just how Yu-Gi-Oh is sometimes. So, Yu-Gi-Oh, it brings out the competitiveness in you. I was actually sitting there talking to my friend Rennie, and he was just like how he's not the biggest fan of Yu-Gi-Oh right now, even though he said that he would never quit. He wants to quit just because of how competitive it is, you know? And as of late, I really haven't been playing Yu-Gi-Oh for fun when it comes to real life. It has literally been, it's time for Dirty Dan. It really has. And even when it comes to, you know, dueling against my friends, we used to have fun, but now it's literally gotten to just getting dirtier and dirtier and dirtier, siding against each other, and it's just like, whoa, where'd the fun go? I remember when we used to sit down and, you know, I'd play my Yubel deck and he plays in Dragoon deck, and we'd just go back and forth, and sometimes I win, sometimes he win, you know. But now it's literally getting to like, well, I have Tower Turbo, and, you know, I'll sack the shit out of you if you don't have the answer. So then, you know, he was like, well, I'm gonna make Bujins who can beat the shit out of Tower Turbo, you know. And it's just like, what's like, what? Like, what's going on here? You know, hello? Gonna go ahead and get Storm so I can go ahead and banish a shit, because I can literally pendulum summon my shit right back. Actually, I should have got rid of the fox. Should have tributed the fox, like, so I could resummon it, but it's fine. My bad. Oh, wait. Which one's the one that banishes? I get all these cards mixed up. I really do. And once again, opponents go ahead and scoops it up. I don't know how many duels I'll get left. I'm really busy. I'm really busy. But I feel like I should get like one more duel. So, be right back. Alright. You know, and that's just, I don't know. Just, you start getting dirtier and dirtier. You feel so dirty. Dirty Dan. Like the episode's fun about. No, I'm Dirty Dan. And like I said, this deck, I definitely feel. This deck is Dirty Dan. This deck is definitely Dirty Dan. Because when I play it, it just, I feel powerful. Power. The power in it, too, you know? Like, I summon fucking Tower in one turn. Qliphort Tower, one of the most powerful monsters all of you get in one fucking turn. How do you not feel powerful with that? Hello? Right? So, yeah, I get power hungry. I can't be power hungry. I play freaking I play you Bell decks. Like, Can I get some victories? Can I heal the power? I don't even know what your field effect is. Oh my god, what is this? Field effect, you can discard and target one card. Okay, so I'm guessing your field effect is a hand effect, so you don't even have a field effect. Okay. Like, literally, everybody knows your scale effect, but I don't think anybody knows your field effect. It's just weird. It's weird. You're weird. You're weird. This archetype is, the Majespecter is just like, what? Yeah. Like, oh, it can't be targeted or destroyed by opponent's card effects. Okay. But I'm going to fuck you up, because when you try to attack me, I'm going to fuck you up with my traps and spells and traps that tribute. And then I'm going to penetrate him in the back and then search more. But he's got that first movement, so he's clearly going to summon Aria. And then, well, his spell summon on the field, his monsters can't be targeted by card effects or destroyed by battle. So I can't even, you know, do my tornado, get him, you know, spin him away. So that is definitely some power. This is, you know, this is a nice counter. It's like, what the fuck do I do against that, you know? Including her, so I can't target her or destroy her by card effects. Like, no, I can't, she can't be targeted by card effects or destroyed by battle. So, you know, what the fuck do I do against that? Why do I have all this shit in here? I don't even think I changed the fucking extra deck from fucking Odd Ice. No, I didn't. Because I'm fucking lazy. So, I don't even know what to fucking do. I don't even know what to do. I got fucking nothing. I really don't need another one of him. He ain't doing shit. He has literally no field effects. I'm just going to pop that. Okay. That was nothing, because I can literally put on something back to the field. Actually, that might be better just to keep it in my hand. This duel's definitely stalemate right now. Definitely a stalemate. Like, what the fuck? I'm just sitting here searching out my fucking trap cards and shit. Can't kill this bitch. Cannot kill her. I have no way of killing her right now. That's crazy. Who would have thought Melodious would be a great fucking counter to fucking Majespecter? Who would have thunk, right? Who would have thunk? What the fuck? What the fuck? You're that bitch. Like I said, if you're not a fucking Melodious, I don't give a fuck. It's Aria protecting all your Melodious. Like, oh my god, it's all I do. All I do is target or destroy the battle. Like, that's all I got. I don't have some sweeping destruction fucking card. This duel's gonna be difficult. You know? I don't even know how long this duel's gonna last until I fucking figure out a way to handle this shit. I want to get Unicorn, though. I know Unicorn's about to put in some work. Yeah, we'll go ahead and normal summon them, so during either player's turn, you can target one Pendulum monster you control or monster your opponent controls, and return them to the hand.
Okay.
And then I can just set up my skill again, so... That's cool. Cool story, bro. Yeah, tribute you, summon you. No, the least thing I can do is at least poke you for 400. You'll die eventually. All I have to do is attack you fucking like 20 times. I'll deck out by then. That's crazy. That's crazy. That's crazy. I'll deck out by then. And, like, none of my monsters... She's 16, too. Like, none of my monsters are strong enough to even fight her head on. Like, that's crazy, too. Like, look at this. Oh, and he can just turn it to defense mode. So then he'll just stop taking damage. Like, that's crazy. I can't do anything against this bitch. I cannot do anything against this bitch. That's crazy. I got fucking nothing. No, that's fine. I wish I had my fucking field spell. A field spell would be great right now. Put that back in hand, I guess. What? What's up?
Can you call me when you finish that on dinner?
Mm-hmm.
Please don't forget this time.
Mm-hmm. No, not you. I'm just getting the same fucking cards. At this point, I'm probably going to be done fucking, searching. Look at this. Look at this. I got the resources out the ass. Can't even handle a fucking Aria. This is kind of sad, actually. It's kind of pathetic. I'm like, oh, Majespecters are going to be so fucking good. I can't even handle fucking Aria. Oh, that's funny. Yeah, I'm all out of chop searches. That's crazy. I got nothing. Shit. Maybe I should just start. I don't know. Do I have any rank 4s? I haven't changed the fucking extra deck since fucking Stanzi, so I'm not even sure what I have. I got Castell, which you can't use. Enjoy, which will do fucking nothing, because they both target. Fucking awesome. Fucking awesome. I should have. I never changed the extra deck. I never do. I can't. This duel's stupid. I literally cannot do anything against this bitch. Oh, my God. Why did they count her? Like, that's the weird thing. Why did they count her? Like, out of all things. Like, you would think that she wouldn't count herself, but she does. It's like, what? What the fuck? Why? So, I guess we'll just continue sitting here. I said, I'm gonna deck out. This is stupid. I got nothing. Like, literally, until I get my field spell, I got nothing. And then all he has to do is literally turn to defense mode, and I can't do shit. Like, if he didn't have this bitch on the field, I would've won this duel already. Look at this! I resourced him like crazy! Look at this, I got fucking resources out the ass compared to him. So swelled with resources. Is that even right? I don't even think that's the correct word to even be saying. Swelled resources? I don't even know. But I can't get around this bitch. I can't. Fuck you, Aria. Fuck you. Fuck you, B. Fuck that bitch. Now he's got another bitch on the field. Man, this sucks. Where's my field spell? I guess I'll fucking get some damage in. Sure. So, do I have anything left? I got fucking you and you. Sure. I'll get you. I'm so swelled with resources that it doesn't even fucking matter. Guess I'll go ahead and summon you. You. I said, but at this point, it's literally just get damage in, because why not? I don't even know what your philosophy is. It's called something that you could target one magician. Your graveyard is out of your hand. Sure. I said, I have something? Oh yeah, I have you in the graveyard. Sure, why not? Why the fuck not? Because this is totally what I need, is more fucking cards. Look at this. Look at this. This duel. This duel. At least you know this is the last duel of the fucking video. Like I said, all he has to do is just turn defense mode and I still can't do shit. And you can just stall me out till I deck out. Say, is Regeki even in here? I don't even know if Regeki's even fucking in here. Regeki would be great. Regeki would be fan-fucking-tastic. There we go. He's already turned defense mode. That's it. Alright. Alright, people. Alright. He's gonna go ahead and summon fucking Song, bitch. Well, this doesn't target. This doesn't activate. Yeah, that doesn't target, so. So, fuck you, Song, bitch. That's why the mirror match is interesting, because this card is just so fucking good in the mirror match, because it doesn't target, so just ret your opponent summons and keep your summons. Yep. This mirror match is kind of stupid. Oh, finally. Terraforming, get my field spell, yes. My job is literally now to do as much damage as I possibly can. That's it. That is my job. That is my job. That is my job. I mean, I guess the only one that's really summoned would be another fox. Yep. Go ahead and special summon, what did the fox say? And get more damage in, like I said. Still got my counter traps and shit. I got all my shit. So it's literally just attack and hope that he keeps the shit in attack because I turn defense mode. Because as soon as he turns defense mode, I ain't doing any more damage. I ain't doing shit anymore. I wish I could get her with my counter trap. But her effect's not... I mean, they show the animation like her effect, but it's really just... Her effect doesn't activate. Her effect is continuous. It's really just reminding you, like, yeah, you know, this is the reason why you're not killing because of her. Like, okay, but no. Look at this. I got beaters. I got damage. I'm putting in at work. I'm putting in at work. But I can't do shit. This is all I can do. This is literally all I can do. So all you have to do is, like, just turn her to defense and then just stall me out. Like, that's it. I can't. Unless Ariel leaves the field, I can't do anything. And all he has to do is just wait 20 turns and deck me out. That's crazy. That's crazy. Man, fuck this bitch too. Like, no, you're not fusion summoning. Like, no. I don't even know why you summoned another Aria. Like, shit. If I were you, I would literally just sit here for fucking 20 turns. Oh. You got rid of her. Oh, then I win. And I win. Why? You were so fucking safe behind that wall that you call Aria. You were safe. All you had to do was just stay in defense mode and wait 20 fucking turns. You'd have won. Like, I don't even care if Regeki's even in this deck. Like, oh my god, you would have had it. Nah. You had to get fucking greedy with the shit. You were like, no. I gotta make Utopia. He's too strong. Like, no, he's not. No. So, you done goofed. You done goofed at. You had it. You'd have had me. I don't even think I could have got out of that situation. Anyway. There we go. We're talking about competitive Yu-Gi-Oh! The darkness competitive Yu-Gi-Oh! So, when I'm Dirty Dan, I don't give a fuck. Alright? And if you guys don't want to hear about my explorations and ventures of Dirty Dan and going locals and, you know, being a dick, then I won't talk about it. It's up to you guys. You know? But y'all don't even need to fucking hate on a nigga. You know? You don't need to hate on me. That's like hating on fucking, like, someone who wins at fucking World of Nationals because they fucking, they outplayed. I mean, they out, that's what it is. I outplayed my opponent. It doesn't matter if my deck is dirty or not. It doesn't matter. They don't have the answer to killer. That's their fault. I win. Who the fuck cares? GG. I win. And in the end of, and when it comes to competitive Yu-Gi-Oh, in the end of the day, that's all it's about, is winning. Charlie Sheen, bitch, alright? Winning. I don't give two fucks, alright? No, nothing ain't about that fun. I mean, sure, I'll shake your hand, GG, whatever, but in the end of the day, ha ha ha, I win. So, yeah, so, y'all fucking hating on me because I'm talking that good shit. Keep hating, then. Unsubscribe, but like I said, go ahead and tell me. I don't have to talk about my competitive ventures. We can just continue just talking about whatever. I don't have to tell you when it goes down local. I thought they'll be happy for me, because you guys know, for the, especially for those of you who've been subscribing to me for a while, Daniel don't win shit. Daniel always loses. So when I win, it's like, huh! You know? It's like, huh! Daniel won! I won something! So, if you guys can't be happy for me, then I won't talk about it. I won't. I won't. It's simple as that. So, there we go. I'm done. I'm done. So, of course, I mean, I'll be going to locals this Saturday. I'll enter. If I win, then I win. Then maybe I'll talk about it. Maybe I won't. Doesn't matter. But, you know, I don't have to talk about it. I don't. I really don't. So, there we go. So, of course, speaking of competitiveness, League. League, of course, this weekend. And terrible times. Terrible times. Like, this week was just terrible for me. I was super busy. I'm super busy. Stanza's super busy. Everybody, hard to get the fucking schedule, you know. And I'm also having a hard time just getting everybody organized, because it seems like I just got to do everything, which I hate. You know, one of the things that I was hoping that people would do when it came to this league thing is that, you know, you have the bracket. You know what week we're on. Go ahead and contact your opponent and, you know, set a schedule. So conversate with them. Why do I have to babysit your fucking conversation? Do I say, hey, is this a good time for you? Hey, is this a good time for you? All right, you know, like, well, no. You guys can talk to each other and be like, hey, we're both available at this time. Is that cool with you, Daniel, to record? Then I'll say yes or no, and then we'll do it accordingly. The majority of the time, it's yes. I'm a pretty free person. But no, I hate running around with my fucking head cut off, a fucking chicken with its head cut off, I'm trying to run around conversating with fucking 8-9 different people about when to fucking do this shit. It's really difficult. So hopefully in season 2, I can get some more reliable people. Anyway, I'm done. So, I hope that you guys enjoy this episode of Daily Duels, and I hope you guys see my point, you know? If I'm Dirty Dan, then I'll stay. I'm Dirty Dan! You know, fuck you, SpongeBob, I'm Dirty Dan! So, but if you guys don't want to hear the competitiveness, then fine. I will just keep it mellow. I'm a chill person. Majority of the time. Alright, people. Thanks for watching.